Hey guys, so in this video, my friend, my mom and I, we went to the local park and we interviewed a bunch of different people and asked them some questions about the ballistic missile threat that happened earlier this morning around 8 o'clock. We had gotten this message saying that we had a ballistic missile threat from North Korea and it sent the entire islands of Hawaii into panic, and everyone was scrambling. We talked to different types of people and they explained their experience and what it was like for them, and it really changed the perception of people's eyes, and that, you know, you gotta like really, you know, take this seriously because it could happen. You know, that it's really scary to wake up in the morning and see that you have a threat. You know, it's something that shouldn't happen, you know. I just wish that this wasn't how our world was now, you know. I just wish it could be a happy place, because I'm pretty sure that's the idea of what it's supposed to be like.
Go ahead and ask.
So when you got the alert on your phone, what was your first instinct?
I was a little nervous. I tried to, like, Google, like, on the news, like, to look up, or I tried to put on the news channel. There was nothing on it, and I tried to look it up to see if it was real. I called my mom, she's born in New Jersey, so I was wondering if there was something on the news there. And I just kept trying to look stuff up until I did find something.
Did you try to take shelter anywhere? Or
no, I did not.
Did you think it was real?
Half and half, I would say. Like, I kind of was like, because it is possible, but then I was kind of was also like, not on the news, like, if I didn't see anywhere else, I was thinking, like, maybe it's, you know, that would have me thinking it wasn't completely true.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
We really appreciate it.
Okay. I'm doing this for fun because I want to see how people reacted when they got the alert on their phone.
Uh-huh.
So what was your first reaction when you got the alert?
My first reaction, I read my phone, and then my husband said, I'm probably gonna cry.
It's okay. We've all been crying.
We were scared. We just got, and I wasn't even crying still.
I know.
Anyway, so he just said, we've got to go. We got in our car and we didn't know where to go. We live by Maui Sunset, so we got in our van. We just grabbed some personal items, some passports, our handbags, our phones, and just went up to Safeway area. Yeah.
How were the people at Safeway in that area?
It was pretty frantic driving. People were running stop signs. There's a big concern. Everyone's driving. It was kind of crazy. In the parking lot, people were going in, buying a lot of food, buying water, buying supplies.
Were there employees in there to help people?
Not really. We got there. There weren't many people there. I don't know if people had left. It seemed like people were coming in, so maybe there was people left. Came in. All the employees were on their phones, calling, trying to call family members, trying to see what was going on. They called a staff meeting, so they just said all personnel come to the meeting room, and people just continued shopping. You know, all the customers were just trying to see if anyone knew what was going on. I was trying to look on the internet. It seemed I couldn't get service. I kept restarting my phones. I don't know if the internet was maybe jammed up. Couldn't call anyone. My husband's from Australia, so I thought, oh, let's call your family and see, maybe have them look on their internet just to see if maybe the Australian news had something different. And then he told us that it was just a false alarm. And then they did announce over the Safeway intercom that it wasn't accurate. But it's probably like 40 minutes.
38 minutes.
Realized, you know, we have like our family tsunami evacuation or hurricane evacuation, but we don't have any
plan. I feel
plan.
Like everyone should start having a plan for this now.
That's the thing, and even for my staff, you know, we didn't know what to do. Luckily, a police officer drove through and we told our employees that it was a false alarm, accident, whatever it was.
Mistake.
So they continued, you know, with their
No one's
running up and down the road.
In our house, we had two types of phones. We had iPhones and non-iPhones. It only came through on the iPhone. So if it had been genuine alert, it would have come through on everybody's phone.
Did it, like, eventually scare you? Did it, like, go to your head's TV or anything?
Well, we just checked to the other side.
Was already on there saying that it was a false alarm. So, although my daughter-in-law, is out on the whaling boat today. So I got a text saying, oh my God, can you please make sure I have little girls on? So I think she got scared.
We live here and we were scared to death.
Really?
Yeah, because it went off all on our phones and all our neighbors' cars. If you had your radio on, the alarm sounded. And it was loud and we would not have been able to hear the siren down here. We were hunkered in a closet for 38 minutes.
Really? There's alarms here, tsunami, isn't there?
Yeah. And there's also, we just had our
but
first...
But they didn't go off, did they?
No, those didn't go off. We have the tsunami warning, and then immediately after, they now have the nuclear war warning. And they just tested it December 1st and January 2nd for these guys.
But it didn't go off this time.
It did not go off, no.
That's what confused me at first, because, you know, I didn't hear that, but, like, it was really scary because a nuclear bomb threat is just horrifyingly scary. And, you know, it puts you into complete panic because, you know, you only have 15 minutes to, you know, prepare. And it's just really sad that people out there sometimes are just going to check the news.
Yeah, I guess.
The other factor, by the way, is we're Australian.
We don't
blame anybody.
Oh, well, good for you. Yeah. I wish I was you today, because I'm a wreck.
Well, we don't have any alerts like that at home, so it kind of didn't have any same impact to us, because it was like, whatever. Yeah. It just can't be amazing. But I understand where you're coming from, where you know that alert was there. So did you find out why it was a false
they
alarm?
Don't, they haven't.
They said that it was a hacker, but then there's also a chance that it was human error,
that it was a mistake.
They accidentally didn't mean to send it, but it sent anyways.
But it's a check and recheck and check system, so it takes three different people to send that alert out, but it was the real alert. That is what we will get when we're under a nuclear attack. Go look for her. Okay, sorry. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
I was afraid that everybody was panicking. No kidding. I was just really didn't know what I was doing.
That's terrible.
So that doesn't happen all the time?
No. No.
I was wondering, I was just by myself. I was like, yeah, I don't know.
No. It was life changing.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
It was quite a long time.
38 minutes, start to finish.
I know.
Oh, no cash. Thank you, though.